Thomas was a tank engine who lived at a big station. He had six small wheels, a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy boiler, and a short stumpy dome.
If you were an English child growing up in the 1940s, among the literature of Peter Rabbit and Winnie the Pooh, one book that was likely on your shelf was a small blue one, titled Thomas the Tank Engine. Written by the Reverend Wilbert Audrey, the four short stories tell the journey of a cheeky little shunter who wants to see the world beyond his station yard, and after trial and error, proves himself a hero and is awarded his own branch line. Following his debut, Thomas would go on to be a household name, with writer-critic Marjorie Fisher saying his stories are fair examples of artless, artful technique that has kept the Railway series in the bestsellers list. Included in the book were 30 illustrations, all colorful and amusing. However, turning back to the title page, you will find that, for the most famous book in the series, no artist is credited for them. It wasn't until the publication of The Thomas the Tank Engine Man in 1995, 49 years after Thomas got his book, that a name was revealed. Reginald Payne was described as an Admiralty artist, and was responsible for how Thomas was portrayed in his book. Following this, Payne suffered a nervous breakdown, being replaced by C. Reginald Dalby for future books. And that's it. Aside from those few mentions, almost nothing else is known about Payne. Over the years, people have tried to find information on him, but his story has remained largely a mystery. What was this man's life before Thomas? What were his other works? And most importantly, what happened to him? So, how do we find Reginald Payne? The most obvious first answer would be to Google it, but that's easier said than done. When searching artist Reginald Payne, a variety of results come up. However, nearly all of them do not match Payne's history, being from not in the same country, to not being born yet or died before Thomas the Tank Engine's publication. And anything that does match Payne is already surface level. My second plan to find Payne was through Ancestry, a website database that collects details on people's past lives. Hoping that there was a record of Payne on there, I filled out the form with the limited information I had, expecting a long list of results and having to look through each one. Instead, however, this was the first and only result that came up: Alexander Reginald Payne. Now at a glance, this may be passed off since Payne goes by Reginald as his first name. However, considering that some people prefer to go by their middle name rather than their first, it's likely Payne did this so as not to be confused with his father, also named Alexander. Going to his fact page, Alexander was shown to have the occupation as a commercial artist, according to the 1939 census, and was living in Reigate, Surrey, in 1945, a year before Thomas the Tank Engine was published. So it does fit the timeline, but what else is there to suggest that this was the same man who drew the little blue engine? Searching Alexander Reginald Payne on Google, one of the first results to come up was an Amazon listing for a book titled Famous Aircraft, published in 1937, with Alexander being credited alongside Howard Coble. The listing, however, didn't show the book's official cover, so I went back to Google, again, to see if I could find the cover, and found another listing, this time from eBay. Alexander was credited as A.R. Payne, both as the book's author and illustrator, the latter as seen in the corners of the artwork. This made me wonder, did Alexander use this signature for his other work? Once again, returning to Google, I checked for an A.R. Payne artist, and among the search results were some Flickr posts of ship and naval drawings with the signature A.R. Payne for the Boy's Own 1937 annual. For those who don't know, The Boy's Own was a series of magazines and books containing various fictional adventure stories and non-fiction articles. The issues were also published in Redhill, a town within the Reigate area, where again, Alexander was living in 1945, likely to be more local with them. Searching A.R. Payne, Boy's Own, on Google, one of the results took me to an index for magazines content, and in the list was a section credited to A.R. Payne, alongside an H. Coble, Howard Coble, whose drawings are also included in the 1937 annual. Another result goes to Comic Book Plus, a website dedicated to archiving comics. One of these archived magazines was the December 1939 issue of Boy's Own Paper, with Payne being credited for an article called British Engineering Achievements. Unfortunately, the full magazine wasn't archived, so I wasn't able to view said article. However, looking further around the site, another boy's own paper was archived, this time the November 1942 issue. Notice something? In the bottom left corner of the cover, you can see Alexander's signature. The artwork itself, showing a naval ship blowing up a U-boat, also parallels the mention of Payne being referred to as an Admiralty artist. Now knowing that Alexander had illustrated covers, I began scrolling through various listings for Boy's Own Paper magazines, month after month, year after year, hoping to find something. As the publications went by, more of Alexander's work came up from the early 1940s. Then, while looking through the 1945 magazines, I came across this for the August issue. A Southern Rally Merchant Navy, specifically 21C4, Cunard White Star, steaming almost out of the cover, and like Alexander's previous work, had his signature in the bottom corner. The magazine was published a few months before Payne would have started illustrating Thomas, and the art style is similar. The buffer beam detail and track is what I compare the most. Regardless, Payne did have some experience with illustrating engines. Speaking of Southern Railway engines, there has always been a major question. Why did Payne illustrate Thomas after an E2 tank engine? Some sources say that Payne chose the E2 because he was a Southern man, and living near Southern Railway stations and drawing artwork of a Southern Railway engine does support that. However, I think there is much more to that claim. In the 1940s, a few of the Southern Railway's E2 tank engines were allocated to Stuart Slane Shed in London and used for station pilot duties around Victoria Station. Edith Gregerson, then Wilbert Audrey's agent for Thomas the Tank Engine, was based in London, so Payne would have had to go up there regardless to discuss the illustrations with her. It's likely that he would have gone by train from Reigate to London, and even more likely went to Victoria Station. Is it possible while there, he would have seen the E2s performing station pilot duties, and knowing that he would be illustrating a book about a station pilot, chose the E2 then and there? This is all speculation, of course, but the fact that this all lines up so well, from Alexander living around the same time and area to having the same career background, it's all but confirmed that this is the Reginald Payne. That being said, here's what, very likely, is the story of Thomas's forgotten artist. Alexander Reginald Payne was born on the 7th of June, 1909, in New Malden, Surrey, to his father Alexander Payne and mother Ada Roberts. In 1911, he had a sister named Millicent, and the two took up a career in illustrating, with Millicent becoming a lettering artist and Alexander going into commercial work. As early as 1935, Payne was working for the Boy's Own Paper, and during this time he collaborated with Howard Coble on several articles, leading to the two publishing their own book, Famous Aircraft, in 1937. By 1939, Payne was living with his sister in Guildford. However, at some point, likely following the outbreak of the Second World War, he joined the Admiralty, and throughout the early 1940s illustrated several Boy's Own Paper covers with naval ships in action, including writing articles about the events happening at sea. After the war, Payne returned to Surrey, now living in Reigate, to continue his work for the Boy's Own Paper, and for the August 1945 magazine did cover art of a Southern Railway Merchant Navy. A couple months later, Payne was approached to illustrate a children's book titled Thomas the Tank Engine. Earlier that summer, Wilbert Audrey had sent the manuscript of Thomas to his publisher Edmund Ward as a companion to his first book, The Free Railway Engines. However, as he was disappointed with the poorly drawn pictures by the previous book's illustrator, William Middleton, Edith Gregerson went searching for a new artist. It's likely that she came across the cover art of the August publication of the Boy's Own Paper, and seen a possible replacement illustrator, contacted Payne. At Ward's request, Payne provided two specimen drawings, which were a vast improvement to Middleton's illustrations. Seeing that they met the requirements, Payne was chosen as Thomas's illustrator in November 1945, and paid £49.10. While Payne had illustrated locomotives before, he found himself unsatisfied with the lack of material he had to draw from, and to avoid inconsistency asked if Wilbert could send some sketches. Wilbert agreed, and after a busy December of family life and clergyman work, sent Payne a collection of drawings in January 1946. Wilbert had used his wooden model of Thomas for reference, drawing him at several different angles. Instead, however, Payne would illustrate Thomas after the E2 tank engines, likely after seeing them during his trips to London to meet Gregerson, although he would follow the original angles from the sketches, and would repeat them for other illustrations. At first, when Wilbert saw Payne's illustrations, he admitted he was annoyed with them, as they were quite different from how he originally designed Thomas. But once he discovered that Payne had based Thomas on a real engine, he was then content with it for further illustrations. Payne worked on Thomas the Tank Engine through the winter and early spring of 1946, and apart from having to go back and add signals to the drawings, on top of falling ill while finishing the final ones, managed to complete the illustrations in April. Thomas the Tank Engine would hit shelves in September 1946, and much like the three railway engines, was a success, going through 8 print runs in its first 4 years. The books would later get the attention of Edmund Ward's new editor, Eric Marriott, who saw a future in them. Around Easter 1948, Wilbert was approached by Edmund Ward to write a third book, which would become James the Red Engine. The manuscript was quickly written, and aside from Payne's track and point work needing improvement, Wilbert still considered them immensely superior to those by Middleton and was happy to have him continue. However, when it came to illustrate the book, Gregerson had some news. Sometime after working on Thomas the Tank Engine, Payne had suffered a nervous breakdown due to his time in the Admiralty, and had since disappeared from view. Upon looking further into Alexander's ancestry record, I discovered that those words may have had a deeper meaning, and that his health issues possibly factored into what happened next. On the 20th of December, 1947, only a few months before Wilbert had started writing James the Red Engine, Alexander Reginald Payne passed away. He was only 38 years old. A week later, he was buried at the Church of St. Mary the Virgin in South Benfleet, Essex, a few miles from Southend-on-Sea, where the rest of his family had since moved to. The story of Reginald Payne is a very unfortunate one. He never got the chance to become the future artist of the Railway series, let alone see the book he illustrated take off. Aside from a few magazines, a book that hasn't been reprinted in several decades, and mentions in a biography for illustrations he was never credited for, Payne's life has almost been lost to time. There was no record of him ever marrying or having children, and his sister died in 1982, so there isn't any family we can contact to ask about him. Even through all my research, I haven't found a single photo of what he looked like. To rub salt further into the wound, in 1950, Payne's replacement, C. Reginald Dalby, painted over Payne's original drawings. Because of this, Dalby is sometimes mistaken as the original artist for Thomas the Tank Engine, and some later editions of the book credit just him, with no mention of Payne. Reginald Payne deserves recognition, because of how important he was to the secret of Thomas's success. Out of the many Railway series characters, Thomas's personality, in his first book at least, is the closest to that of a child. He is a character with enthusiastic, good-natured optimism, a character in love with life. It makes us sympathize with him and his failings, and delight in his success. He is an inspired creation. While Wilbert was the one that wrote Thomas, it was Payne that brought him to life, portraying the tank engine with features of a young child. Anxious, alarmed, sorry, sad, and in one picture looking like a tired 5-year-old. In other illustrations, Thomas is eager, innocent, and wide awake. Payne had drawn Thomas to where children could look at him and relate with him. Because let's face it, children are more attached to illustrations than words in a book.
They were extraordinarily easy to sell because of the single opening of each page with a picture on one side and story on the other. And selling these books to a bookseller in a busy shop, you could speak to them over the pictures. They didn't read the text, they looked at the pictures.
I want Payne to be remembered for his impact on Thomas, so I'd like to share something. After the premiere of this video ends, I will add a link in the description to a Google Drive full of his work outside of Thomas that I've been able to collect so far. I hope this encourages viewers to go out and to help properly document his contributions, so if you have something to add to Payne's story, please tag me on Twitter. With his drawings of ships, planes, and trains, we can keep Payne's legacy alive, because as Wilbert's biographer Brian Sibley put it, Uncredited as they are, his illustrations are inseparable from Wilbert Audrey's Thomas the Tank Engine. Reginald Payne is responsible for having created one of the icons of our age. And I'm sure you can agree, he was right.